On this cold night, and I can't sleep, I decided to watch Les Misérables, and it's a very intense film. I've seen it a few times, about six now. And oh, actually, make that seven. I forgot I watched it on the way home 2 years ago when I toured with my company back east in New York. Everyone on the plane around me was checking me out. I could not stop crying to save my life. It's one of those heart-wrenching stories and so beautiful. Redemption, forgiveness, justice, mercy, kindness, love. It was really a great film. Watch it or read it. Isn't it Victor Hugo who wrote that? I could be wrong. You need to read it. And a lot of people don't really understand what this film is about. It is about God moving through us to show love and mercy. There are many other themes, but that's one of the biggest ones. It's about an uprising and a revolution. Common folk became warriors to fight for what they love. They didn't want to be controlled anymore. But in watching this film, I'm realizing something. Our hearts beat strong and loud. We desire to know truth. We really do. And I just want to reach out to you and encourage you that God can use many things to open doors, to open our hearts. He can use films, songs, dances, other people, a kind heart, a smile. Be wise. Be like Jean Valjean and don't push away that person. Because I don't know if you all understand the gravity of this. You know where I'm coming from as a born-again Christian. The thing is, we could be the ones that are tying the noose around our own necks and not even realize it. I almost did it. I almost pushed away my husband. But I didn't. On February 10th, quite a few years ago, I found my true love. I found it in my husband, and I also found it in my God, my Lord and Savior. And He was there for me every step of the way. Every February 10th is more than just an anniversary for my wedding day, but it's truly when I became the bride for the Lord. And I gave my heart and I surrendered my callousness, my bitterness, my hate, my envy, my jealousy, my pain, my fears, my insecurities. So I laid it all at the foot of the cross. And before I said I do to Christopher, I said I do to the Lord. And it was such a sweet, soft knocking on my heart. It's just like a soft knock on a door. I said, "Hi." It's really kind of dopey sounding. I didn't have a very climactic transformation at all. Leading up to it was another story, the car accident that almost killed my mom, and it was pretty traumatic, all the events leading up to it. But my salvation day was so beautiful and soft and gentle. No drama, just beauty and peace. So, I had two fathers who led me down the aisle. I've had many dads, and the two that were there, one was my biological father, and the other one was my stepdad. He was a Jewish man. He was something else. And they both led me down the aisle, and they both held my hand. And then they gave my hands to the preacher. And then he gave my hand to my husband. But more importantly, my husband gave my hand and he said, "You have my hand. Take my hand. Now take the Lord's." And I took the Lord's hand. It was a beautiful day. I just want you to know that it takes a lot of courage to take that step into freedom. But once you do, you will breathe like you have never breathed before. All that crustiness around your heart will fall away. Oh, sure, you'll remember the things of old. It just won't hurt as much. And sure, you'll still have those scars. But you know what? You can be healed. You can be whole. You can then show off your scars. Take those skeletons out of your closet and make them dance. That's what I do. You'll no longer feel shame and no longer feel the need to impose that upon other people. You can be friends with God and reconcile. So I encourage you, go ahead. Watch or read Les Miserables and just open your heart. Remember, to love another person is to see the face of God.